Hello everyone and welcome back to our very next video for English literature. Before we start with our chapter, let's do a warm-up exercise.
Can you see these things scattered around on the ground? Do you think it belongs here? Then where does it belong?
Now I want you to find out the right place where you think that we should place all these things. Well, you all are amazingly smart.
All these trash must go into a trash can.
When we throw garbage on the ground, instead of putting it into a trash can, it is called littering.
I guess by now you all should have got an idea about our chapter. This chapter that we are going to learn today is related to environmental issues. The name of the story is
A Cloud of Trash,
written by Karanjit Kaur.
Do you know who is Karanjit Kaur? She is deputy editor of Array. She has also written for National Geography, Traveler India, Mint Lodge, Caravan and Time Out. Let's start our chapter
A Cloud of Trash
with the mind map. Here you can see Chiku never listens to anyone and keeps littering things. Next day she gets up with
a cloud of trash.
This
cloud of trash
would never leave her till one day she stops another boy from littering waste.
Next day the cloud becomes small.
Now Chiku knows what to do. We must keep our surrounding clean. So here we are done with our mind map. Let's read and understand our chapter word by word.
You all can open at page number 51.
Let's start our chapter 7, A Cloud of Trash.
Chiku was the unhappiest girl among her friends. She was the unhappiest girl in the world. Friends? Chiku had no friends anymore. No one wanted to play with Chiku because she had a cloud hanging over her head.
A cloud of trash.
What is trash? Anything that is thrown away because it is not wanted. Orange peels and biscuit packets, broken toys and pencil shavings, twisted plastic bottles and colorful plastic bags, all surrounded by a swarm of buzzing flies. Swarm means a very large number of insects moving together. No one wanted to play with a girl who had a cloud of trash hanging over her. Chiku even had to eat lunch all alone. So here in this paragraph tells us about a girl named Chiku, who is the most unhappiest girl, not only among her friends, but also in the whole world. She had no friends and no one ever wanted to play with her. Do you know why? Because a cloud of trash was always hanging over her head. So here, in this paragraph, the author describes the trash that are found around the girl, like orange peel and biscuit packets, broken toys and pencil shavings, twisted plastic bottles and color plastic bags. These are the things that were there in her cloud of trash, and it was surrounded by large buzzing flies. So no one wanted to play with her as she had a cloud of trash hanging over her head. because of which she had to eat her lunch all alone.
Chiku knew that she should have listened to her Amma. Amma always told her not to litter. Do not throw the banana peel on the road. Throw the empty biscuit packet in the dustbin. But Chiku never listened. She only laughed and kept littering. Then one day, Amma became very angry. "Soon, all this trash will start following you," she said.
Now Chiku had realized that she should have listened to her mother when her mother told her not to litter, saying, what did her mother say? That you should not throw banana peel on the road and you should put empty biscuit packets in the dustbin. But she never listened, but only kept littering around. Seeing this, her mother got angry one day and told her, all that you are throwing will follow you wherever you go. So when mother got angry, she told that whatever you are throwing around will follow you one day. The next morning, Chiku woke up to a foul smell and the sounds of buzzing flies. Here, foul means very bad smell. The cloud of trash was hanging over her head. Amma's word had come true. And then Chiku was unable to laugh. Chiku tried to run away, but the trash cloud followed her everywhere. She screamed and asked the cloud to leave her alone. She even tried throwing the cloud into the dustbin, but the cloud of trash just would not go. So Chiku became very unhappy. Here we can see what happened next day. Do you know what happened next day? When Chiku woke up, there was a foul smell and buzzing flies all around her. Do you know why there was a foul smell and buzzing flies? That is because when waste gets rotten, it gives out a very bad smell and attracts flies all around it. These flies had come because of all the waste that she had littered. The cloud of trash was hanging over her head. What her mother said had come true. We can see here that Chiku couldn't laugh. She even tried to run away, but this trash of cloud followed her everywhere she went. She screamed, she shouted, but could not. But the cloud would not leave her. Even she tried to throw the cloud into the dustbin, but it would never leave her. All this made Chiku very sad. Then something happened. Chiku saw Bala throwing a banana peel on the road. Chiku was angry. Could he not see the cloud over her head? "Oh, foolish boy," she yelled. "Do not throw the peel on the road. Someone will slip." Bala, scared of the trash cloud, threw the peel in the dustbin. The next day, the trash cloud had become smaller. How did that happen? Chiku thought. Chiku smiled. She knew what she had to do. So here we can see One day, something happened. Do you know what? Yes, there was another boy, Bala, who threw banana peel on the road. Was it a good action? No, isn't it? So here, seeing this, even Chiku got angry. She also shouted at that boy, saying, "Do not throw peel on the road. Someone will slip."
Now when Bala saw the cloud of trash on her head, he got scared
and threw the banana peel in the dustbin. You know what happened the next day? The trash cloud had become smaller. How did that happen? Even Chiku thought the same thing. Can you guess what might had happened? But Chiku knew what had happened. She smiled. She knew what she had to do next. When someone threw away a biscuit packet or pencil shavings, Chiku stopped them. She picked up every twisted plastic bottle and put it in the dustbin. The village became cleaner and cleaner, and Chiku's cloud became smaller and smaller, until one day it was gone, completely gone. Chiku was now perhaps the happiest girl in the world. Chiku never littered again. She liked living in a clean village. Now, what do you think? What would Chiku do from now onwards? Yes. Now, whenever someone threw any trash away, she stopped them. She started picking up all the waste that she could see and put it in the dustbin. The village became cleaner and cleaner, and her cloud of trash became smaller and smaller, until one day it was completely gone. Do you know what happened to Chiku? She was now the happiest girl in the world. She had stopped littering and liked to live in a clean village. So what do we understand after reading this chapter? First point, we must keep our surrounding clean. We must not litter things around. We must put all the garbage inside the dustbin. And the last point, we must throw the garbage inside the dustbin. Do you all want to meet Chiku? Well, why wait for? So let's go and meet her. Chiku never listens to anyone and keeps littering things around. Mother gets angry and she says, "Soon all this trash will follow you." Next day, she gets up with a cloud of trash. This cloud of trash would never leave her. Wherever she went, it followed her. She tried even to throw it. She shouted on it. Still, it would not leave her. Till one day, she stops another boy from littering waste. Next day,
a cloud of trash
became small. Now, Chiku knows what to do. We must keep our surrounding clean. Now you know how you can keep your surrounding clean.
Now the activity for this chapter is, from now on you all have to help your mother and father to keep your house clean. Also, you have to stop any other people from littering, or if you see them making your surroundings dirty. Hope you all have understood the chapter. Meet you in our next video. Study well. Take care. Bye.